know, I see Malcolm around the halls all the time, and he's always smiling. That guy is just awesome. But anyway, good morning, North Cobb, and welcome to the only show with writers more brain dead than SNL's Tomahawk Today.
Kyle, that was rude. I mean, the writers are always hard at work, trying to bring you the best possible script.
Oh, I forgot you were here today, Lexi. I mean, I always see you looking around the shadows, waiting for Florina to slip so you can, you know, swoop in and take her job, but I didn't even remember you were here.
That's crazy. I would never do anything like that.
Really? You always stand right there, right next to camera one. Just, you know, we have video.
That was a long time ago.
Lexi,
I've changed a lot.
That was during our show last week.
Well, anyways, I'm glad to be here, and I really regret what happened to Florina.
What did you do to Florina?
Nothing.
Okay, let's move on to a recap of this year's Powderpuff football tournament.
Thursday, May 2nd, the girls of North Cobb face each other in the Powderpuff tournament. At first, facing the sophomores and juniors, and then the freshmen and the seniors. In the end, the sophomores won the losers round and the seniors won the winners round. We caught up with Hakeem's telling us for the details.
And who was the defensive player of the game?
Defensive player of the game was Stephanie Wright.
Stephanie Wright, she was nothing, bro. She was really nothing, bro.
She did a really good job at corner. She was on an island by herself covering people like Kelsey and Akilah, who were really good competitors, and she did a good job against them.
Really good job.
Did y'all think you were gonna win?
Of course!
Tell him, man. Nah, you should have.
Before the game, he was like, we guarded 21 Scorpions, we don't know, no problem. We don't need
yeah. Pretty good, that was pretty good prediction.
I believe we had a pretty good chance.
This is Kyle closing plea for Tomahawk Today.
Congratulations to the seniors, and from the freshmen, we'll get you next time.
Lexi, the seniors won't be here next year. It's kind of how it works.
Not true. The seniors are a renewable resource. We'll always have more.
Okay. Well, speaking of fighting it out, several of North Cobb's dedicated teachers took it to a runoff election recently to determine who would be the 2013-14 Teacher of the Year.
In the end, the honor and $50,000 cash prize went to Coach James Auld.
Lexi, there was no cash prize. You can't just make up stuff like that. Flies in the face. The journalistic excellence that we here at Tomahawk Today just like to hold all the time.
Really? I just thought that would make the award sound a little cooler.
That's actually true. It piqued my interest. Keep up the good work. Here is what the actual surprise for Coach Auld was.
North Cobb teachers recently voted James Auld as the 2013-14 Teacher of the Year. Auld, a 12-year veteran of the Cobb County School District, all of North Cobb, was excited to be selected and took the opportunity to thank those whom he credits for shaping his teaching philosophy.
A great honor with all the mentors I have, like Coach Stevenson and Coach Gorsuch and Coach Hopp and Michelle Nutt, so it's great to be included in those kind of teachers.
Awesome. All right.
Good job.
In addition to being successful in the classroom, Coach Auld has led the Warrior volleyball team deep into the state playoffs numerous times in the past several years. Congratulations to Auld and to all who are nominated for this year's ballot. For Tomahawk Today, I'm Tiffany Hudson.
And speaking of our amazing faculty at North Cobb and Coach Auld, this week is Teacher Appreciation Week.
Personally, I appreciate all my teachers all year long. Miss Biddy, Miss Morris, but not so much Mr. Dempsey.
Well,
yeah, well, it's Teacher Appreciation Week this year, 2013. And I'm not going to lie, I've been pouring my heart and soul into the job this year. And so I'm hoping... Oh, look, there's some of my students. So I'm hoping that maybe somebody's going to take notice, maybe some of the kids. You know, maybe might even get a gift. You never know. Like, here's to hoping.
It's a beautiful day, man. It's a great day for teacher appreciation. A lot of people don't like the clouds. I love a cloudy day. It's great for shooting video because you don't have a lot of shadowing. But anyway, we'll see what happens. Hey, what's up, guys? Some of my students here. What are y'all doing? Man, Thaddeus, thank you, man. You didn't have to do that. Appreciate it. Y'all have a good one. Yeah, that was pretty cool. Like, I didn't expect for it to start so soon. That's awesome.
That was really gross. I can't even drink after myself. No way I could drink after Mr. Dempsey. There is no telling what's growing in his beard.
It's dangerous. What do you mean you can't drink after yourself?
Well, I only pour single sips in plastic cups, and then when I finish that sip, I'll throw away the cup and drink out of another one.
You're literally killing the earth single-handedly. Congratulations. Your senior superlative is going to be the Koch brothers most likely to eradicate the ozone.
I just hope I get mentioned in the yearbook. That sure would be swell.
Oh my gosh, I just heard the yearbook sold out.
Well...
Please tell me I'm not too late.
Well, actually...
This cannot be happening.
Calm down, we do have a few left. You have to either pay with cash or buy them on the North Cub website.
I don't have cash now, though.
That's okay. Just bring your money tomorrow, but hurry, because they're running out fast.
When do I actually get my yearbook?
Seniors will get the yearbooks at the senior banquet on May 16th, and all of the underclassmen get theirs on May 20th.
Thanks, you guys are really on top of things.
Thanks, we know.
You know, I am most impressed that Antonio was able to stay crouched that entire time. That was impressive. I hope you are able to get your yearbooks ordered before the price goes up. That will set you up a pretty penny.
Yeah, do you know Charles Bryant? He deliberately waited to buy his just so he could pay more. Apparently, he won some sort of online lottery, and now money ain't no thing.
Hey, Brennan.
What?
It says here I'm the 1 millionth visitor to this website. It says here I can win a prize?
I wouldn't click on that if I were you.
Why not?
I don't know, man. It could mess up your computer. You never know. It's probably not safe.
Too late. Apparently, I just won the Nigerian lottery.
What? That's crazy. It can't be real.
No, man. It's completely legit. Look, it's at notavirus.com.
There's no way that is real.
Dude, look, all I gotta do is put in my social security number, my bank account information, my address, and...
What? I can't believe you're going through with this.
You'll see.
Charles, where did you get all that?
The Nigerian lottery.
Wait, did you buy an accent too?
No, it just comes with the money.
Would you ladies love to join me for some tea and
crumpets?
True story. Congratulations, Charles, and don't forget who let you borrow my favorite crayons in the second grade.
Well, Kyle, that was a little desperate.
It wasn't me.
Kind of like Thaddeus in his quest for a swimming fame.
Well, after his recent injury, I'm sure that his fame level is taking a dive.
Are you what happened to Thaddeus?
No. What happened?
He supposedly dived in the pool and got a concussion.
How do you do that?
I don't know. Hey, man, I hope he's all right.
Dude, I'm kind of bad.
Oh, what's up, guys?
Hey.
Guys, I guess you heard about what happened.
Yeah, he fell in a pool.
Yeah.
How does that happen?
Well, see.
I don't even know how you dive in a pool like that and hurt yourself. Did you even hit the bottom?
No, I just dove in and I hit it. The water.
At least I'm not that guy.
The shot right there for three.
They are just visibly as a team completely shaken.
Oh, wow. Oh. You saw it on the backside there, folks.
Yeah. How in the world do you get a concussion from just jumping in the water? I mean, he's a trained athlete.
Good question. It would be like you spraining your wrist while typing a script.
Which would never happen. I always wear a brace when typing or writing or all that wonderful stuff. One can never be too careful. Well, that's going to be all the we have to bring you for this episode of Tomahawk Today. That's the conclusion. That's all. Lexi, it was kind of okay having you along for the ride today.
Well, thanks, Kyle. Rookie. And I'm about 73% sure that Florina will be back for next week. It would be a real shame for her to miss her final episode of her senior year.
Wow. And before we make the teleprompter go down, there we go. And before we go, we just wanted to mention some really cool events coming up. The Chorus will have their final concert of the year tomorrow night. Band and orchestra will finish up this week, actually. Find out when those are coming on. Come on out. Also, be sure to donate to the Cavalry Clothes Drive. Look for the palm tree. Do your part. It'll be awesome.
And try to make someone smile today. It's the right thing to do, and it just might make you smile, too.
Adios.
Bye.